How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Prestige, and this is episode number 3 of The Road to Gold. In this video, we're going to be focusing our attention on the semi-automatic SVT-40. Back in the early 1930s, there was a man by the name of Fedor Tokarev who actually came up with the design concept of the SVT rifle. By 1939, full production of the SVT-38 had begun, and there were over 150,000 units created. Unfortunately, the unreliable nature of the SVT-38 caused for a lot of concern and complaints from the soldiers using them in the battlefield. Many complaining they're just too hard to maintain and clean because of the barrel length, they're too bulky and heavy to haul around, and the biggest one by far, the magazine would just fall out in the middle of a gunfight. Obviously, this is something you don't want happening if your life depends on it. Because of these issues, the SVT-38 was completely terminated, and by 1940, the SVT-40 went into full production, creating over 1 million units for the Soviet Union. There were many different variations made between 1940 and 1945 as well, including a sniper variant that was capable of killing at 1,100 yards, and a fully automatic version called the AVT-40, which subsequently had its automatic fire mode prohibited because of how much damage it would cause the rifle, and it was just really unreliable at the time. But let's hop back into Call of Duty World War II. How reliable is this weapon in-game? Well, the first thing you need to know is it's a two-shot kill pretty much at any range. I've noticed that longer ranges it can take 3 shots if you happen to hit a piece of material, but for the most part, you're going to be getting 2-shot kills. This is most definitely a medium to long-range engagement rifle. If you're using it at close range, you can pretty much consider yourself dead because the fire rate is not that high. One way to alleviate this problem is by representing the infantry division. If you guys end up using this, then of course you will have a bayonet at the end of your weapon, and well, if you find yourself getting into a mess, you can clean yourself up by creating a new one, if you catch my drift. Attachments that I personally like to use would happen to be the rapid fire, just so I can shoot it a little bit faster. I really like to use the grip, which is kind of redundant for a semi-automatic weapon, but there is a pretty decent amount of kick, and I do have a reason for using this, which I'll explain in just a moment. And then beyond that, I like to switch between the 4x optic, the red dot, or just have the iron sights on there so I can use a quick draw handle or anything of the sort like that. Of course, as of right now, the best basic training to use, especially when it comes to semi-automatic weapons, happens to be primed. And that, of course, allows you to flinch less while being shot at and apply an additional attachment to your weapon. While using the infantry division, you're allowed to have 4 total attachments, which means you could pretty much deck out this weapon any way you see fit. Let's go ahead and switch the conversation, talk about the very first set of camouflage challenges. This is where a lot of people are going to slip up and have issues, and that is, of course, getting 100 headshots. Now, the SVT-40, as a semi-automatic weapon, suffers the same exact issue that the M1 Grand has, in which you cannot get a one-shot headshot while using the high caliber attachment. It's still going to take you 2 shots, which makes the high caliber attachment pretty much null and void. However, I will be honest with you, it does help in situations where maybe an enemy is through material. You could shoot through said material once and then pop them with the headshot a second time. However, it doesn't really matter once again because this is still such a powerful weapon. It's a 2-shot kill if you hit him in the head anyway. The headshot multiplier is not that much greater with the high caliber attachment, so I would just recommend staying away from this altogether. There are a few game modes that I would recommend. If you are used to playing Core, you could jump into a game of War. This is going to be an easy way for you to snag those headshots, especially if you have people on the bridge trying to build it, building specific walls or any other material, building turrets. You're going to be able to take out people that are in the tank cockpit. This is super easy to do, especially in this mode where people are unable to move. As long as you're locked on their head, it's only going to take a 2-pop. If you are super impatient like myself, then you might want to hop into a game of hardcore. It doesn't matter what mode you play, just know that this weapon is going to completely demolish people that are in front of you. You have to make sure you are 100% locked on their head when you pull that trigger, though, because this is such a powerful rifle, it's going to get a 1-shot kill no matter where you hit them and no matter the distance in this particular mode. You could hit somebody in the big toe from 500 meters and you'd still be getting a 1-shot kill. So in this, it's going to take accuracy, and that is the key to getting headshots with this particular weapon. Earlier on in the video, I was talking about how I like to use the grip, but it's kind of redundant, and that's because it's a semi-automatic weapon. There isn't much pop, and you pause in between shots, so it's not going to be constant recoil, but it still helps in the long run, because if you're free-firing this weapon pretty quickly, and you do have rapid-fire attached, you could aim for the upper chest, and then the second pop will normally hit them in the head. I've also noticed the SVT-40, while firing it as quickly as possible, has a lot of horizontal kick. This is something that I don't really see with many weapons in Call of Duty, but it's going to move left and right when you're shooting. This doesn't actually seem to impact where the bullets go either, which is strange. So even if your weapon is going left and right and going all over the place, your bullets are still going straight, which is strange. I just wanted to point that out. I did find more luck in war, admittedly, more than hardcore, just because the weapon itself isn't weak by any standards. The only downside to having hardcore is everything is super powerful, so a one-shot kill is bound to happen to you as well. If you're aiming for the headshot, trying to line it up, it's possible that you might just get killed by a teammate or just happen to get hit by a stray bullet from somebody else that you didn't even notice was there. As for the rest of the challenges, they're pretty easy to complete. 50 kills in the infantry division, 50 kills outside of the infantry division, 10 long shot medals, 2 fast kills 5 times, and then you have the 5 kills that we've already talked about, and then you'll have gold. It's all really easy once you don't have to focus on getting a headshot. Body shots with this weapon are actually very, very satisfying, especially when you get paired up against somebody trying to use the STG, the PPSH, or hell, even something like the Johnson. But anyway, guys, that is going to conclude today's episode of The Road to Gold. If you guys have any idea on what weapon you would like to see next, please leave it down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed the video here today and enjoyed the history and learned something new, take a moment of your time to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, my friends, I'll see ya. Peace.